Collaborative learning is a process for engaging with a diverse group of people. It's a process for creating equitable space to talk about complex and contentious topics like climate change. And it allows for people who otherwise wouldn't be able to contribute to these conversations to have the opportunity to do so.
What tends to happen is that experts with scientific knowledge will come in and share that knowledge with a group, but when they don't take the time to also listen to what the local community is experiencing, they miss out on an opportunity.
We've been focusing on adaptation and climate change and faith and what that means for various people. We've got pastors and church members participating in these conversations, as well as researchers here from the University of Maryland and folks from state agencies and county agencies.
One of the things that the project does very well is enable local community members who may not have the formal education to be able to comfortably express their opinion in a forum that they will not feel demeaned or disparaged.
Something that's really interesting that we're finding is somebody will be very dogmatic about a position on climate change, but later on they'll be quite flexible. So views on climate change are not static, they evolve and change. Collaborative learning gives us these opportunities to let people express a range of viewpoints, including their uncertainties. And we haven't found anyone that doesn't think climate is changing, but why it's changing and what to do about it is the challenging topic.
It's always a challenge when you need to bring bad news. Climate change is not good news. For these communities, they are losing their livelihoods, they are losing their land, and they are seeing that the land is eroding. What we are doing is to actually get to know the people, get to talk to them in an environment that's friendly, it's open, safe. You learn from them.
A lot of our research is in rural coastal areas, and these are unincorporated areas. They have county government, but it's usually in a town located far away. So they have to rely on other social institutions, such as civic groups, and most importantly, the churches.
Churches are really a valuable resource. They're a social institution that's commonly found in rural areas, and they can serve as a sort of conduit for information.
Being involved in this collaborative has really been wonderful. Number one, if nothing else, we feel empowered. This collaborative has brought us together face to face. We've learned a great amount about the issues that are facing us. It's been an excellent opportunity to get access, you know, to what we needed.
We've really come to understand what these faith-based perspectives on climate change are, where people of conservative faith backgrounds often feel left out, and how we can open the conversation more to include them.
Right now, I am worried that we've come this far and we can't go any further. And I would hope that collaborations could continue. I would hope that we created, or at least began to create, the kind of networking with local government and with other entities to the point that we can begin to make some serious plans.
Rural communities are at risk of losing quite a bit. They risk losing those close relationships and social networks that they've built up over generations if they're forced to relocate. These rural areas have this cultural heritage that is really important and rich.
If we don't find ways to help these communities, then I think it's going to be a real loss in terms of how we understand this place and what it means and what we value about it as a region, and how we celebrate it.